Our sport knows how to celebrate those special moments, the pageantry, the legacy, wonderful stuff. And I'm coming to you first, Lotz, because you saw Marty St. Louis and his greatness up close. It must have been special to see him go into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, it really was. And I had an opportunity, obviously, as the general manager of the Tampa Bay Lightning, to see Marty up close and personal on a daily basis. And I couldn't have imagined a better person, a better professional, a better leader for young players that we had like Stamkos and Hedman to see on a daily basis. Marty personifies everything you want in a professional hockey player. And on top of that, he's just as good off the ice. Gary Bettman, on the other hand, what a milestone moment for him. A guy that'll be known as bringing the National Hockey League from a bit of a boutique basis to the behemoth it is today. He came up with dynamic ideas like being a little bit more geographic around the country as we saw expansion. He's driven this league forward in revenues. He's done a magnificent job. He's a friend. He's been an adversary when I was an agent, when I was a player. But I love the things he's done with the National Hockey League. And on top of it all, he really is an incredibly nice guy when you get to know him one-on-one. Congratulations to Gary Bettman as well.
Both of those guys, family men, that came across loud and clear. Both had great speeches, and you really got to understand who they are as people. Big hearts, both those guys. Weeksy, coming to you on Willie O'Ree. My favorite thing that's ever aired on NHL Network was your sit-down with him. I know it meant so much to you to see him take his rightful place in the Hall of Fame.
Thank you so much, Tone. Yeah, it does. And, I mean, it's great for our game, beyond myself, more importantly for the real breadth of our game, because he had the courage to aspire to be an NHL player and, of course, the tenacity and commitment and skill level to become one and being the first black player in the history of our sport. It was historic. But it didn't end there. It was entire professional career and his post-playing career as well, in him championing the sport for girls and boys and parents and a lot of the different volunteers and coaches to aspire to be a part of our great game. So congrats to him. My former teammate Marty Brodeur, I had a chance to visit with at the Prudential Center there, really the house that he built a couple of days ago. And I said to him, Marty, 691 wins.
Come on.
You kidding me? That's Gretzky-esque.
Come on.
Really, he was the Gretzky of our position in between the pipes. And it's only fitting that after all the years of excellence and dominance for him, for the New Jersey Devils, that he takes his rightful place by being enshrined in the Hall. So congrats to him as well.